Welcome friends to another episode of Renfort Tech. Let us do a little bit of red gram cultivation. Red gram is usually cultivated in this area during rainy season. The seeds are sown during rainy season and the reap is obtained just after the winter. So this time during the rainy season I put some seeds and the crop has grown up. Now it is flowering season and we don't have rains here. So I am planning to use a drip, so and I have put the drip lines. Now the next problem that I am facing is to supply water to the drips. Here I had a couple of things to consider. Number one, I am staying far away from this field, so I have a problem in switching on the motor regularly. Second thing, this area is a bit of dry land, so quantity of water in the borewell is less. So now with those things, I had a couple of options. One option was just to tie the drip system directly to the borewell. However, I foresee one problem, that if for some reason the drip pipes get clogged up while I am not here, there is a possibility of junctions just opening up and the water getting lost everywhere. So I have come up with another innovative way utilizing the gravitational force of Earth. I will just show you how it is done. It is strike to me because I am already having a 3000 liter tank in the center part of the agricultural land. Here what I am trying to do is from the bore I am filling the water through this pipe, and what I want this to do is to hold the water till the tank gets filled. Basically, because if I use the valve at the bottom side and keep it always open, the pressure will not build up and the drip may fail. So here is what I am doing. Friends, this is what we are trying to do. Inspired by our ancient Krishna's magic jar, which works on the principle of siphoning, we will design a drip system which pulls water from a tank that is kept on the floor. So this is how we will be doing it. As I have shown you, I have a 3000 liter tank which is kept on the floor. So the tank lies like this, and the covering here, it has a borewell input of coming here, and then there is a drain pipe that is kept here. This is a drain side. So from the drain side, we already have a pipe, or we are already doing a pipe connection that will be running into the drip system through a valve and a filter. A filter to basically filter out any of the dust particles that comes along with the water in the tank. So this is the design. Now here, because the system is going to be a long one, there will be a chance of an airlock also. So to prevent the airlock, we will have one pipe implemented somewhere here. This part I am right now not sure as to where exactly it should come. And we will close the top with some with a dummy which is having holes in there to prevent any leaves from falling into the pipe and choking it. Now, when we speak about the siphoning effect, how we can achieve is that is by having another pipe within the tank submerged in the water, something like this. So here what happens is when you have the borewell on and the water coming in, it starts filling the tank. Like this. Once the level of the water rises above the drain pipe,
water starts flowing out this way. And as per science, what is told is because of the cohesive force that is exerted between the molecules of water, the water flowing out will be having much more pressure than the water that is coming out from the regular outlet vent. So I am planning to use this feature because it should ideally give me a cost benefit also, because if I am implementing a drip system in a regular field, I have to keep the tank on some stand which takes the water tank to a higher level so that we can build up the pressure from the outlet. Now with this method, I think I will be having better pressure even though I will be keeping the tank on the floor, and thereby saving cost for the elevation tool that is needed, or elevation materials that is needed. Now to automate the whole stuff, I have to do one more thing. Main problem for me is switching on the pump. How can we achieve this? The only way we can achieve this, or at least we have a couple of ways in which we can achieve. One, by using a timer switch. Two, by using a GSM motor controller. The first one is cheap and effective. However, I lack control. I don't have any control on it. GSM motor controller is relatively costly. However, I have full control on when to switch on and when to switch off. So I'll be using a GSM motor controller for automating the switching on of borewell and switching off of borewell. There are a lot of companies that are coming up with GSM motor controller. I am using a company called Samarth, who is a startup. Initially I had tried using Crompton, but that failed. That failed in the sense this controller started hanging every 2 days and it failed my purpose. So I had to buy another one. Most of the GSM motor controllers will be having at least two modes of operation. One will be a SMS mode and the other would be a voice control mode. In SMS control mode, the user will be sending an SMS to switch on the motor, switch off the motor, or you have timer controls and you can access various other functionalities of the GSM motor controller which the GSM seller has provided. Now using the voice control also you can do similar things. However, when using the SMS mode, even sending SMS can be automated by apps that are available either in Google Play Store or maybe in other places where these things are used. So with that, you can even schedule outgoing SMS at odd hours to utilize the high or proper voltages that will be available in the agriculture field. Once everybody switches on the motors, the voltage drops. So you can select odd hours for switching on the motor. That's another advantage. So here you can automate switching on of borewell through GSM controller. You can automate the SMS sendings for GSM controller using apps. Only thing you will have to take care is whenever a fault occurs at the other side, you may get a callback or in some way, some complex way, the manufacturer would have sent an alert message which will be reaching us indicating some fault mode. We'll have to react to those fault modes. That's the only thing we have to do.
This is the connection I am making on the 3000 liter water tank. So first I'll be doing the connection from the outlet, I mean overflow outlet. No, I'm not using the outlet that is used for draining the water from bottom side of the tank. Instead I am using the drain pipe from the overflow side. And here what I have done is into this I have kept a pipe up to 1/4 level of the tank. So now what will happen is once the water gets filled in the tank, then only the water will start overflowing. Once the water starts overflowing, actually the water in the tank is full, and the pressure that is exerted by the full water due to the siphoning of water that happens within the tank is high, and that actually gives me much more pressure than taking water from the lower part. Now to complete the connection, I have to put a filter, this filter. So when you connect the filter, just see this arrow mark. This arrow mark indicates the input of water. So I have to connect it this way. However, since this filter involves some cleaning and all, this filter involves some cleaning, I am going to keep a valve in between and then keep the filter here. I'll do that and then show. Now I have connected it this way, so water comes in, get filtered, and goes through this pipe to the drip. I'm having a disadvantage with this one. Due to some reason, for around 30 seconds water overflows like this before starting to move through the pipe. I don't know the reason. There's some kind of airlock somewhere. You can see the water has started dripping. So this is one quick way to have a water dripper installed with a low pressure, low kind of investment. Well, I think I understand why the airlock is occurring, and to resolve that issue, what I am going to do is I am going to move this air pipe. This pipe is supposed to output the air when water is siphoned through the other pipe, but somehow that's not happening properly. Basically, maybe the reason is because I have kept it in the lower side. So what I am going to do is I am going to pull this pipe and place it directly over here. Only thing you should be careful about is always the height of this air pipe should be above the tank. So I am going to cut it here and install this pipe over there. I'll talk to you after that. Well, I have done the modification. So now I didn't have a U bend, so I didn't have a L bend. So I had to put a T bend and I put a dummy out here. And this is how it would be. So the top dummy is actually punctured. There are holes in that one so that leaves from the tree will not fall into the pipe. So I have switched on the motor. Let us wait and see whether the water flows this time without overflowing. Well friends, that seems to have done the trick. Now I am worried about another thing. See, since I have kept the joint here, that's just half a palm height from just half a palm height, so probably the suction may happen only up to this level, because air should be entering through this one and stopping the suction. I'm not sure at this point of time. However, let us wait and see. As you can see, the dripping also has started. So right now, from a working perspective and wastage of water perspective, this is working fine.
but let us see how much of water will be dripped out.
Well, friends, the way I had earlier set it up with the air vent at this top location did not work out properly. Basically, because once the water got filled, it directly started flowing through, and unfortunately, the system could not build the pressure. So next, as an experiment, what I have done is I moved the pipe to around 1 feet above the ground. Here I got a good result. There was no leakage of water, and the pressure also is good, and the dripping is happening everywhere. So I think I'll be leaving it there. However, I can even experiment it to move a little more further down, so that the water in the tank will be filling a bit more and then starting to flow. But I'm not going to give it a try right now due to time constraints and all. So this is working fine now. So this is an easy way to make your drip system for a half an acre to 1 acre work, depending on the elevation on your agricultural land. Friends, even though we had a good learning out here, some of you would already have been knowing this, and for me the water flow was kind of learning. We have finally achieved the target, so this is working fine. Thank you, friends, for watching this. Please support me by subscribing. If you like the video, give a thumbs up. Your comments are most welcome. Please share this idea through others to others, so that they also get benefited.